Many of us will be aware of the gospel song, "We Shall Overcome." It's been sung widely over the years and has also in fact been sung by some as a kind of protest song. But as regards life itself, and in particular the problem which we now face with the coronavirus, my question is whether we shall actually overcome, or shall we be overcome? As long as we live in this fallen world, trials and pain and wounds are in fact unavoidable. Our experiences of life will differ in detail and in degrees. But every one of us will suffer in one way or another along the way. We'll all encounter situations that provide fertile ground for all sorts of difficulties, as well as for resentment and unforgiveness to take root in our hearts. But there's something else which may not be so obvious, but which I believe needs to be underlined. And that's that the outcome of our lives is not determined by the present struggles which we face along life's journey, or by how other people might treat us. The outcome of our lives is determined by how we respond to these difficult times and difficult situations. In other words, by how we respond to this lockdown in which we find ourselves, by how we respond to the daily challenges which come our way, and by how we respond to the many different people whom we meet on a regular basis, some whom we might value a great deal, but others whom we might find somewhat difficult. It's true that we'll be affected by every painful circumstance with which we have to cope in everyday life. But no matter how difficult these might be, they don't have all the power to control the outcome of who we are. They don't possess the authority to declare us victims, that is, as people who have been overcome, rather than as people who are overcomers. Some people might think that this is in fact bad news simply because it throws the burden of responsibility back to us. It would seem to leave us to blame for the problems and the issues which we have. But that said, I believe that being able to acknowledge this truth is actually vital if we are to progress in any way with God and in any walk with God which we currently have. The reality is that when believers come to realize that his truth is sufficient for every situation, then they are no longer victims in that they are overcome, they are overcomers. They are able to rise above and move on beyond whatever may have happened or be happening. They are able to know God's grace themselves and to be instruments of grace and reconciliation and redemption in the lives of struggling people. They can therefore be true overcomers. I'm reminded of Jesus' words in John 16, verse 33. "I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world." Can I ask if these words are real for us? We don't have to be overcome by the situations which we face in the world around us. We don't have to be overcome by the coronavirus pandemic, nor by the many other difficulties which we might face, simply because by God's grace, it's possible to walk in peace and wholeness and joy, even when we are struggling. I pray that we might be found to be trusting in Jesus for ourselves, that his forgiveness might be known by us, and that through faith and through claiming the promises of his word, that we might be overcomers and not those who are overcome. The chorus says, "We shall overcome by faith in Christ, I do believe. We shall overcome someday." I pray that such a reality would be ours.